In part 2 of our lesson on products and quotients of complex numbers, you will learn how to multiply and divide complex numbers in trig form. In an earlier lesson, we learned the product and quotient rules, so let's remind ourselves that z1 times z2 is equal to r1 r2 cis theta 1 plus theta 2, and z1 over z2 is equal to r1 over r2 cis theta 1 minus theta 2. And we will use these two rules in the next example. Here, we're given that z1 is equal to 4 cis pi over 6, and z2 is equal to 8 cis 2 pi over 3. We have to find the product, z1, z2, and the quotient, z1 over z2, and we have to put our answers in both trig form, using radian angles, and rectangular form. z1, z2 is equal to r1, r2, cis, theta 1 plus theta 2. We know that r1 is equal to 4, r2 is equal to 8, cis, theta 1 is pi over 6, and theta 2 is 2 pi over 3. This is going to equal 4 times 8, which is 32 cis. We need to take the sum of these two angles. So we can come off on the side here to do this. Our common denominator is going to be 6. So this will be pi over 6 plus 4 pi over 6, which is equal to 5 pi over 6. So we enter that, 5 pi over 6. And this is the trig form of the solution. Next, we want to put our answer into rectangular form. So we will rewrite this as 32 times the quantity cosine of 5 pi over 6 plus I times the sine of 5 pi over 6. And all we did here was write the shorthand form out in the expanded trig form. This will become 32. Now we need to find the trig function values of 5 pi over 6. We know that 5 pi over 6 is here in quadrant 2, and its reference angle is pi over 6. So going to our special angle chart in the pi over 6 column down to the cosine row, we see that the value is rad 3 over 2, and we know in quadrant 2 cosine will be negative. So this is negative radical 3 over 2 plus I times the sine of 5 pi over 6, again, referring to our special angle chart in the pi over 6 column, we see the sine is a half, and in quadrant 2, it will be positive. Now we just need to distribute that 32, and we get negative 16 radical 3 plus 16i, and this is the rectangular form. Next, we will find the quotient z1 divided by z2, so we are using the quotient rule, which tells us to do r1 divided by r2 cis theta 1 minus theta 2. We know that r1 is 4, r2 is 8, cis theta 1 is pi over 6 minus theta 2, which is 2 pi over 3. Simplifying, this is 1/2 cis. Let's go off on the side to do the subtraction of the fractions. We have pi over 6 minus 4 pi over 6 is negative 3 pi over 6, which is negative pi over 2. If we are here at negative pi over 2, we know that that will be coterminal with 3 pi over 2, so that's the angle we'll use. 3 pi over 2, and this would be the trig form. To convert to rectangular form, we expand out and get 1/2 times the quantity cosine 3 pi over 2 plus I sine of 3 pi over 2, which is equal to 1/2 times. We know that the cosine of 3 pi over 2 is 0, plus I, the sine of 3 pi over 2 is negative 1. So this is equal to 0 minus 1/2 I, or it's fine to write it as negative 1/2 I. And this would be your rectangular form.